Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reaction to Whitney Houston, and we are going to react to the song Greatest Love of All.
I've heard the song before, so let's see what Kinti thinks about it first.
Okay.
Since it's her first time reaction, and then I'll contribute later.
Show them all the beauty they possess inside.
was that at the end? I thought it was not part of the song. I have also heard the song, not by Whitney Houston, maybe a cover. Somewhere on the net, yeah. And I remembered some of the lines, and those lines are very easy and very, very inspiring, the way it is written. Whoever wrote this song, I don't know whether it is Whitney Houston or she's co-written it or who is the real writer, but did a good job in writing it. So
I don't think she wrote more.
No, none.
Her best songs, I don't think she wrote them at all.
Okay. And it makes sense actually, because if you look at her life, personal life too, none of these things she could follow in her life anyway.
I was just going to say that retrospect, the way things worked out for her and the way her life ended, and even her kid's life, you know, the girl, the daughter, I don't think this at all inspired them, either of them, to do something with their life.
Or did they understand it,
It's very sad, but this is a good example of how little the lyrics matter to a musician or a singer when they don't follow it in their own life or it didn't work for them, even if they followed it.
I instantly thought of it because we know a little bit, at least I know a little bit about a personal life. If I didn't know, I wouldn't say it. But because it is out there in the open and with lyrics like this, which are only talking about the personal growth and knowing yourself and things like that, love yourself, it is a contradiction.
She would have still been alive had she turned to meditation instead of the bottle.
Yeah, exactly.
Instead of the bottle.
Yeah.
If she had turned to meditation, she would still be alive with us today.
Mm. She would have.
And most other people who have succumbed to the bottle or to the needle, they would still be around today if they turned to meditation instead of these vices.
Right. So, those,
that is a bigger lesson for anyone watching this reaction video than this song.
Than the song.
Turn to meditation, not the needle or the bottle.
In Hindi we say, I don't know, I think in English also there is a saying, but I haven't read it, and I'm sure you know, people may know that the darkest place is right below the candle, or we call it diya. Right below that is the darkest place. So she may have you know, inspired so many people with lyrics like that, but people wouldn't have known at that time that she is going through the darkest.
Oh, by the way, David Foster wrote most of her songs.
Okay.
So that tells you a lot about her songs and her lyrics. You know.
But the way she sang this one is amazing. You actually, you ought to get inspired when you listen to a person who sings
like that.
Her heart out.
The way she sings is absolutely beautiful. I don't think there are too many singers. I don't think there are more than three singers
who can do it.
In the female genre who could sing like her or be close to her.
Yeah.
She is absolutely beautiful when she sings like that. Hats off to her. You give her anything to sing, which is apparently what probably happened here. And she'll sing her heart out.
Sang it great.
That's the beauty of Whitney Houston. Was the beauty of Whitney Houston.
Thank you for watching.